believe in our heart. Let's take our reading from the book of Romans. Romans 10, let's go to the proof text of today. Verse 9, this is where we are going now. If you declare with your mouth, take note of that. If you declare with your mouth, Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be what? You'll be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and justify, and it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved. Take note of that. Let's go to the 1 John chapter 5, verse 13. I write these things to you who believe in the name of the Son of God, so that you may know that you have what? Eternal life. This is the confidence we have in approaching God. This is the confidence we have in approaching God. If you believe in your heart, Jesus is Lord, you are what? Huh? You are what? He who believes has eternal life. The instant you believe, you have. Our spirit act upon the way to declare this. The power that flows from his name, the name Jesus, will be in proportion to our love for his way. It is the way dwelling in you, which is equivalent to Christ's personal being in you. That is, it is the way dominating you is the lordship of Christ in you. The people asking me, why miracle, why healing, why this, why prophecy is not happening everywhere? Yes. God is going to withhold the phenomena of signs and wonder from the church until two things, What are the two things? The word and the spirit. You can be sound in doctrine and be lost. You can know words and be lost and not be converted. Take note of that. It is possible to be sound in doctrine. It is possible to know word of God and be lost, because our spirit act upon the way. Open your Bible to 1 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 5. And also the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 4. In that 1 Corinthians 2, verse 4, it said, my preaching and my teaching were not only with where, but also with a demonstration of power of Holy Ghost. When you are calling the name Jesus, it is the word dominating you, which equivalent to Christ's personal being in you. The word dominating you is the Christ you are calling. Tell your neighbor. If there is no indwelling where, and you are calling the name Jesus, you are calling him in vain. In the name of Jesus will not come to to the sin if his will has not dominated you or rules you. Open the book of Acts 20, verse 32. God commends us to the way of his grace. This way builds the Christ nature and love nature into individuals. In other words, God is building himself into us, making himself a part of us as the way dominates, rules, and satisfies our spirit nature. The power, like I have said, that flows from his name, Jesus' name, the power you realize from his name will be in proportion to your love for his word. The spirit will be released to the degree we stand in reverence of his word. Tell your neighbor, the spirit will be released to the degree we stand in reverence of his word. We are saved by a gospel that tells us that Jesus Christ died on the cross for our sin and rose from what? From death. Hearing this word and embrace it by faith is what saves us. The blood he shed on the cross of Calvary is the most precious commodity in the history of mankind. The blood he dripped from his son, from his feet, and from his head. The blood of Jesus.
The blood of Jesus sets me free from sin and sorrow. The blood of Jesus sets me free. The blood of Jesus sets me free from sin and sorrow.
The blood Jesus shed on the cross of Calvary has no comparison. The blood that dripped from his hand, the blood that dripped from his feet, the blood that dripped from his head, most precious commodity in the history of mankind. Remember, Christ dwells in our heart through faith. Christ dwells in our heart through what? Through faith. The word dominating you is what you are calling when you say in the name of Jesus. Power that flows from his name will be in proportion to our love for his word. There is a wonderful name, Jesus. There is a wonderful name, Jesus. Listen to that. That's a wonderful name. Jesus. The power that flows from his name will be in proportion to our love for his word. The Spirit will be released to the degree we stand in reverence of his word. What is the Spirit? In every step, the Spirit must suggest. Before I open my mouth, the Spirit must suggest what to say. If I'm to speak of God, there is power in our mouth. The belief in our heart is released by faith out of our mouth. If there's power in our mouth, yes, everyone has power then. If you have not realized your power, it means the proportion of your love for his word cannot release the power. As a result of the proportion of love for his word that causes you what? To be powerless. Let me give you a good example. If the word dominating my brother here, that word is equivalent to Christ's personal being. Meaning is Christ. Because the Bible says Christ dwells in our heart through faith. So now it means you have Christ in your heart. If you now stretch your hand now and say, in the name of Jesus, it is the word that dominating you that will come out. That is, you are calling. But the Bible says Christ and the word are one. But if the word are not dominating you, and you are calling Christ, you cannot bring Christ into the scene. So what is the way out now, sir?
Is to yield to the Spirit of God.
How do we do that?
By studying the word of God.
Not only study the word of God. Not only you must hear the word with your ear. You must also hear the word with your
heart.
With your heart. And the question of how do we hear the word with our heart? Ask me.
How do we hear the word of God with our heart?
To hear God's word with our heart requires openness and hunger for God's word. Openness and hunger for God's word. See God's word as if your life depends on knowing it. Indeed, our life depends on knowing it. Thank you.